there is this historic partnership that WGBH and Masterpiece have had with these British counterparts and production companies. How does that serve you now, especially in this world of the others, the Amazons, the Netflixes?
The others. Well, it's the golden rule, you know. He who has the gold makes the rules. It is a very volatile television landscape. I'm sure you all know this because you have so many choices of what to watch, as do we. So how does that affect us? Well, in a way, it's an opportunity because Masterpiece is above all a curated series. I mean, I think of myself as the curator, the chooser of what I think you would want to see. And that does a lot of work for you, arguably for the viewer already. In other words, it's an anthology series with a history and a brand, and you can't get brands like Masterpiece anymore. I don't think there'll ever be a series that lasts for 50 years in our future. So we have a niche of high-end British drama, mostly costume drama, lots of adaptations, and mysteries. And they are usually fairly cerebral mysteries. We used to say we did non-bloody murders. You know, we just, the thinking man's murder. They're getting a little bloodier now. So I think there is an opportunity for us to be niche, but a big niche, and to be there when you're trying to figure out, or when a viewer is trying to figure out, I feel like watching drama, what, to come here, and practically anything you would find here would be kind of in that wheelhouse of high-end British drama. So that's the good part. The bad part is that there are entities with extremely deep pockets, and they're the story of the Crown. So here's, I mean, that should have been on Masterpiece, shouldn't it? And the people who produced it are people in England who had produced for us. They had done Wallander for us. We knew them. And yet they took it straight to Netflix and Amazon and Showtime. And apparently they walked into the guy's office at Netflix and he just wrote the check right there, because it was so perfect for what Netflix was trying to do, and it was a whopper check. So there will be things like that which the big entities need for global reasons, for business reasons, rather than the way we program, which is kind of specifically for our audience, knowing very well who our audience is, but hoping to bring in younger people all the time. Interestingly, the Masterpiece audience, the average age of Masterpiece, what do you think it is? Yeah, 60s. And yet, it has been 60s for as long as I've been doing this job. So, is everybody just frozen there, or what's the deal? Or somebody said, well, yeah, they all died, but nobody turned the TV off. But that's